Today we are looking at Mem. Now, we reviewed Mem a fair time ago. It is a note-taking app that has AI baked into it. And as many of you know, I was very skeptical at the start. The application sort of didn't know where it's heading, but they've got a brand new Mem 2 out, and we're going to take a look at whether it's worth your time and your attention. So a big thanks to Zapier for sponsoring today's video. Zapier are leaders in AI automation, and you can find a little bit more about them below, but a little bit more about them later on in this video. So before we begin this video, I'm actually an investor in Mem, weirdly enough. I invested in their Series A funding, a very, very small amount, but nonetheless, just to be aware. Now, I am giving you my full honest opinion of this, and I've always given you that ever since I did invest. Just so you know, full disclosure, of course. But you know me, I'm brutal, even if it means giving good feedback, of course. So this isn't going to be like a review because we're just revisiting it. We're looking at some of the features and seeing what's actually changed. And there's a few things that's changed in 2.0. Apparently they've cleaned up the infrastructure. It is available on desktop, Mac, Windows, iOS, and has a web app. I believe when I last checked out, the iOS app was not available as a functional app on the App Store. It was a test flight app, but now it is a fully versioned app. And it doesn't have a lot of the features it has anymore. It doesn't have task management, and it doesn't have some of the other more in-depth abilities with workflows, I believe. It's more centric around integrations. So their focus now is on being an AI-powered knowledge base. So let's take a look at what works. So this right here is Mem, and there's sort of a couple of features that you need to know. There's one called Notes, which is just your notes. And over here, you can narrow them down. There's this window up here that you can pull up called Chat. And this essentially allows you to have a communication with a note or just in general, and it uses your knowledge base to have a conversation with it. Now, Mem were actually probably one of the first ones to move on this when it first came out, but now it is very much old hat in terms of most note-taking apps have a type of experience on this. I believe Reflect does, Capacities, Cortex, Evernote, I believe, are looking at this. There are so many apps that have this AI chat when you can talk to your notes that it is not a unique feature anymore. But nonetheless, they have it on this side over here. They also have something called Copilot, and this essentially scans through all of your notes and finds the most suitable or related note that is best for you. So it's brought up this one here, the SOD, and you can see it's also got other things like launch timelines, because it's obviously reading the note in more detail and trying to work out what one's most suitable. So that's quite a helpful feature, but weirdly enough, it shouldn't necessarily be called Copilot, because that's just quite a confusing name for it. I'd call it just called Related Notes. But at the same time, maybe its features will expand more in the future. So notes can be organized into these things called collections, and they can be done manually or they can be done automatically. And you can create a collection to distill a certain type of focus, which is great. But there's no way of prompting the system exactly what notes you want organized or filtered into them. So again, not as AI focused as it was before. I believe they automatically did that before, but with this, I feel like it's still manually organized. Now, integrations wise, there is email integration where you can forward stuff and create notes from your emails. There's an API and there's a Zapier integration. Thanks to Zapier today for sponsoring this video. Here's a little bit more about them. Did you know that over 1.3 million people use Zapier with AI? This can help you save time, optimize repetitive tasks, and get more done. Zapier helps you to create workflows and automation by building simple or complex workflows and connecting nearly 8,000 integrations. Zapier is one of the leaders in AI automation, and that's why over 3.4 million companies use Zapier to get things done. Get started today for free down in the link in the description. So all in all, those are the core features, and weirdly enough, they've really stripped back compared to what they had before. Some things that are notably better that since I've been playing around with it, I've found is that the speed of the app is a lot faster. So before they were fast, but they are much faster now in terms of the abilities. Like you can use full markdown in here, and I'm just looking at my notes. There's also real-time syncing between devices, which it was not good syncing between iOS and the likes of the Mac version, I remember historically. And that's sort of all in terms of the general experience. The feel and the minimal elements of the application, the interface, hasn't really changed dramatically. Settings is very much thinned down. It sort of reminds me, in a way, of a very skinny version of the app where they're just essentially working out where to go ahead. So just to give you some more context, they are directly linked with OpenAI. So they're actually part of the OpenAI fund, I believe, and OpenAI led the Series A funding for $23.5 million. So you'll see on the books, OpenAI and me. What a weird combo, which valued the company at $100 million over that, I believe. And it's interesting because that's sort of good in a way, because you then have the latest capabilities in terms of what the AI model can do. For example, like they'll probably get access to things like the latest version of ChatGPT to basically build off the API and things like that. So that's really good news. So they probably have just been getting their infrastructure in place before they do something like that. But at the same time, the application does have that advantage above some others potentially. So my honest opinion on this application is it still doesn't know what it is. It claims on its site to be the AI knowledge base, and it points itself towards productivity people, startup founders, and those, I believe, who are in product. But it doesn't really feel like a compelling proposition to really jump in. Now, the application, to its credit, is a lot faster, it's a lot better. It actually feels like a finished application versus this really complex application that was a bit overwhelming trying to be everything. But Mem lost their initial advantage. They were one of the first ones to do an AI note-taking application. And I genuinely believe that was perfectly placed at the time, but I think they just got overcomplicated and they missed the mark on what they could do. Whereas this feels like a lot better in terms of the quality of application, but they haven't got any major advantage right now. If they can find their market fit, whether you guys would use it, and they find new features that match to that, they could have a really good product. I mean, it's really good if you want a note-taking application that's fully baked into AI and that probably has more AI features coming faster than many others. But at the same time, right now, I wouldn't necessarily recommend it above apps like Capacities or apps like Tana, for example, that have been doing much more eccentric things with artificial intelligence. So that's my genuine take. I do believe that they could step up and go for founders and busy professionals that are more in the superhuman for note-taking apps market. That would probably be a good bet for them. But if they had a lot of focus on AI note-taking, like with your meetings, with calendar, scheduling and planning, and deep insights from your notes, and being able to pull together integrations from other platforms so that you can open up your mem and you can see exactly your plane ticket that's coming up, all of the latest notes from the meeting that you've just had, or an agenda already pre-created for you. I believe that's where Mem should go versus where they're going right now. Maybe they are. Maybe I'm preempting this, but let's see. I don't know anything. Thank you so much for stopping by. I hope you found this overview of Mem an interesting one. I hope it gave you some insights, but a big thank you for stopping by on this video. If you want to subscribe, you can do, and I'm sure I'll see you in a future video, I'm sure. Cheerio for now.